Tasha Davis, and for the next 30 minutes, we'll take a journey through the people and stories that make up UCSB Athletics. This is Gauchos In 30. Wrapping up their seasons at home this past weekend were the Gauchos baseball and softball teams. Let's take a quick look at how the UCSB men's baseball team did in their last home series.
I would say yesterday played great defense. I mean, best defensive effort from the entire team that I've ever been a part of in my career. Our starting pitchers Friday and Saturday gave us a chance to win both days. Every weekend in the Big West is difficult. There's no free passes. There's nobody to beat up on. You have to bring your A game every single day, and we didn't do that today. And the scoreboard showed that. This is too good of a conference. I think it's the fifth best conference or something in the nation. And every team's got the ability to beat you in different ways. They're a scrappy team, and you know, today they scrapped and they out-scrapped us, and we didn't play to our ability, and the scoreboard showed that. So I would say that's just a testament to our conference and shows that you got to bring it every day.
We came out the first 2 days. We struggled a little bit on Friday, and we pulled out a win. And yesterday I thought we came together really well as a team, and we played good team defense and had good hits when we needed them. We had clutch hits. They have a scrappy team. They've struggled a little bit in the past, I know, but they have a scrappy team who wants to win, and they want to beat you every day. So I think more so than what they did, I think we kind of beat ourselves today, and we didn't come through in clutch situations.
It's emotional. You know, these are my best friends. Life's going to be full of ups and downs, and I don't know where it's going to take me. I don't know where it's going to take them, but the memories I've made with these guys, the friendships, the relationships I have with these people, I'll never have with anybody ever again. And I feel truly blessed to have gotten to be out here and blood, sweat, tears, smiles with all these guys. And Cuneo, Israel, Morrow, those guys, I'm seniors, you know, we're all seniors. And, you know, those are my best friends. And the entire group, you know, I'm never going to get to play with another group like this again. And I am truly blessed and truly thankful that I've gotten to spend this much time with these guys. And wish them the best of luck down the road.
I mean, guys like this, you can't say enough about Joey. I know he gets a lot of praise, but that's because he deserves it. I mean, he comes out every day and he gives everything he can. I know that he would lay it down for me in any situation, on and off the field. He would do anything for us. So, I mean, I love playing with this guy as a person and as a teammate.
This team is more heart and more love for each other than any team in the Big West. And we're leaving this field knowing that we had an incredible year and a lot of fight, and we had a lot of fun. And I'm proud of each and every one of my teammates. And regardless of how it ended, this was a really good weekend. You know, we came out swinging, we put up 6 runs, and we were loud, and we were having fun, and, you know, and then they came up, and we were down by 3, and we fought.
This team never gave up. Even to the end, we were still down. You know, we were down by more than one or a few in a couple games, and they punched right back. You know, that's just been the hallmark of this team throughout the entire season, is that can't ever count us out. You know, batters 1 through 9, players 1 through 19. They played together this weekend, and that's what we wanted from them, that's what we asked of them, and that's what they delivered. I think just, you know, generally putting the ball in play and taking advantage of any kind of misplayed balls. Players did a good job of swinging at some better pitches and working at bats. So when we did have success, it was working ABs and, again, kind of working with each other and stringing hits together. Yeah, I mean, from the start, we've talked about 2014 being a really special year, and a lot of that has to do with who the leaders of your team are, and it starts with the senior class and just the chemistry and how they've worked together on and off the field. And you know, it's been a really special year, and it would have been amazing to be able to cap it off with the first ever conference title. But I mean, even that, this is the best kind of winning percentage that this program's ever had. You know, being able to tie the most wins in a season, there are definitely things that this group have to be proud of throughout this entire year. And you know, I'm proud of how they've, it's just, in you know, the whole process of them getting here and being able to see them grow up, and then now sending them out as leaders is one of the most successful years in the program. It's exciting for them, and it's been an honor to be able to coach them.
is Jessica Emde, and I'm on the women's track and field team. I'm currently a member of SOB, and I intern in the sports marketing office, and I just recently got involved with the mentor program. Right now in SOB, we're working on the Big West Coin Drive, and the Big West Coin Drive is a competition between all the Big West schools to raise money for our chosen foundations. I also intern in the sports marketing office at UCSB. Being involved in an internship on campus is a great opportunity to learn how to work in a professional workplace. Being an intern has taught me a lot about expectations and time management in the professional world. The best influences in my life come from my family, my mom, my dad, and sometimes even my little brother. I would say someone who's made a big difference in my life has been my grandma. Having my grandma as a mentor has changed my life, and she's influenced everything I do. So when I found out about the mentor program in Santa Barbara, I couldn't wait to get involved. The mentor program is a local organization in Santa Barbara, and it takes kids who are referred by either their teachers or their parents, and it pairs them with a mentor. From personal experience, I know what a mentor means to me, and I would like to give that feeling to someone else. Isla Vista Elementary is currently in need of mentors, and I encourage all students to get involved in the community. Small things that we do as students can make a big difference in the lives of young children. Being involved with the community, being an athlete, being a student, being an intern, and being a member of groups on campus can be a lot of things to handle. Even though I'm highly involved, I would say that my life is pretty balanced and I enjoy everything I do. I think it's important to make the best out of every situation, especially when given the amazing opportunities that I've been given by coming to UCSB.
Road trips with you, and us going to Fresno, and I can remember some of these things.
They were great. They were over the top.
Yeah,
it's nice to see you.
Appreciate it. Good to see you too. How's everything going?
You look great.
Thank you.
If you wanted me to tie your tie, but
no, I'm not wearing a tie. Good. I didn't do the tie thing.
Good.
I did that for enough years. I don't have to do
that.
No,
isn't that nice?
And the way you teach is important too.
Right.
They believe in what you're doing. They know it can be successful. That is neat. Thank you so much for doing that, dude. I appreciate that.
We appreciate you.
Yeah, thank you.
And
thanks.
I just love you being honored.
I appreciate that. Thanks again. That's just super.
If you would have seen that, this banner, you're going to see at halftime. You would have seen it 3 years earlier if you didn't fight me on it. congratulations, coach. Thank you.
Mark. I appreciate it. Thank you. My assistants worked hard to get the players. When we got them here, we worked real hard to keep them in school and get them degrees. And the players and the coaches deserve a lot of this credit tonight. And it was not just the coaches and the players. It was a lot of people that were involved. And all of you that were there in 83 when we started, stayed there with us all the way through and are still here rooting for Bob's program. And hopefully tonight we can culminate this thing tonight with a victory over UNLV. This team has a chance to be something special. Thank you. You gonna go watch the game, Nick? Good. Gotta root for the Gauchos. Yeah, we got a lot of traffic now. Should be a good sellout, they said. I'm mic'd up, and so we're all set.
I've been in barber for 23 years.
That's right.
We went from the curly hair to the straight black hair.
Yeah, he used to do my afros.
Started right, you know, and not get overly psyched, you know.
strong around the back. He can finish. Yeah. But he can finish with guys beating on him, you know. So that's I think that's a good thing.
Jenessa Jepessen. I'm a junior infielder on the softball team. I've been playing softball since I was 5 years old, and I have such vivid memories of going out to the field with my dad and playing catch and standing on the wrong side of the bag and having my coach have to move me, running the bases backwards. My teammates always joke with me about my level of pain tolerance that I have, because the morning before I ended up going to the hospital, I ran stadiums with the team, and then a few hours later decided to go see a doctor. I ended up being diagnosed with a severe kidney infection. I had a white blood cell count of 48,000 and was admitted into the ICU, and I was there for a week and ended up going into septic shock, which is where the fluid that they're giving you to help like level all your vital signs goes into your lungs and your heart. And it caused me to get pneumonia, so I was there for an extra few more days. But I think the thing that helped me the most is my teammates came and visited me every day. It was nice to always get messages from my coach, and I just felt more like I was part of a family. Because when you're down here, it's your home away from home. And they really are your family. You spend every day with them. Because I had to take medical leave last winter, I am a quarter behind in school. So I'm trying to take extra classes and take summer school classes to try to catch up. But I'm really determined to make this next quarter my best quarter academically. I'm really grateful for all the support that I've received over the past year with my family, my friends, and my teammates. Now that I'm back, I feel stronger than ever, healthier than ever, and I'm really excited to take on the season with my team.
Everyone, I'm Taja Davis from UCSB Athletics, and tonight is the annual dinner to celebrate this year's Living Scholars here at the Montecito Biltmore Four Seasons Hotel. Through the Gaucho Fund, the Living Scholars program produces a priceless connection between student athletes and their donors. Let's take a look to see what the night has in store for our Gauchos.
I think this is a happy evening for our celebration. I want to thank every Living Scholar for your generous support. Giving them the money to support them, you also support them spiritually, like a family. That bonding is just fantastic. One of the biggest reward of working at the UC Santa Barbara is to watch the Gaucho game. Somebody asked me, how long have you been here? I have been here, and then Don Bernstein knows about it. I came here with Don Bernstein 20 years ago. So that was the year you were born. This is a family, and I want to thank each and every one of our coaches. You work so hard and you lead our team. You are the example model of the Gaucho spirit to our students. Also, I want to thank our students. You are the exemplary model for our students. You do everything, and you know how that is to excel academically and also to excel in athletics.
Good girl. Nice. Oi. Come on, come on. Feel it. It's all about starting close to the impact. Yes! Yes! I'm winning! Ah, oh, bravo!
Hi, I'm Simon Thibodeau, the new women's tennis coach here at UCSB. I'm from Montreal, which is a bit more a French part of Canada, so it's a little bit more European, so Santa Barbara reminds me a little bit more of that because of the culture. Different weather, obviously. But yeah, no, very good quality of people. I was national coach of Canada for 5 years, working with the best juniors. So I got to travel all around the world, met a lot of coaches, young players. And it never occurred to me to be a college coach until I was at the US Open 1 year and everybody was recruiting some of my players. And actually they recruited me as an assistant coach instead of my player. And that's how I started at University of Arizona as an assistant.
Let's move our feet to hit deeper every time to have good impact and use your legs.
I'm pretty dynamic, I would say. I don't scream after the team, but I'm pretty intense. I'm very demanding in terms of attitude and effort, and I like them to be coachable. But also they can always come talk to me in the office, and I'm very human, and I like to treat them like adults.
This?
Nope.
This?
I have a daughter who's almost 9 years old, name is Camelia, which I say hi, I miss her a lot. So during school year, I don't see her much, but we Skype almost a couple of times a week and we talk on the phone. We have one time during the week that I have to Skype before she goes to bed, and with the difference of time, I have to leave one time a week, practice a little earlier, but luckily I have my assistant Karlon that can take over the team when I'm gone.
I like it. Ready? That's Kiki. Nice. Oh! Nice.
Getting better. The goal is to win the Big West Conference. I think we can achieve that this year. We have a young team. They're all improving so far. And just look forward to start the competition. But winning the Big West, making it to the NCAA would be a good goal for this year. Everyone in California wants to come to UCSB. The location's great. Now we just need a great tennis team, and we already have great girls that wants to improve, so it starts really well here this year.
Good job, you.
Good job. Yeah?
For years, the University of California has been able to provide Californians with an affordable, world-class education.
Last year, UC gave out more grants and scholarships than ever before.
But even with that financial help, most students still need loans,
part-time jobs, or both to pay for their education.
Let's make a promise to change that.
It begins now with the Promise for Education, a new kind of crowdfunding platform.
Here's how it works. You make a promise.
I got a promise.
Bungee jump!
I kind of have two that I've been throwing around.
I will work at a soup kitchen for 2,000 hours.
I'm a rep as President Obama, if there's any indication.
After you made a promise, set a goal.
It can be $10.
It could be $100, $1,000.
$1,000,000.
And you share it on Facebook or
Twitter.
Or what I use, Pimmstagram.
You share it with your mom or your dad or your friends, and you rally your friends.
And their friends and their friends' friends.
To contribute money towards your goal.
And remember, every little bit makes a difference.
At the end of the program, all the contributions made will be used to create
more UC scholarships. That's good news.
We need everyone to participate. Students,
Californians, Americans,
alumni, teachers, anyone who cares about education to make this a success.
Help change the future by supporting scholarships for students in need.
A lot of students like myself.
Like us. First generation.
Start by making a promise.
Make a promise for education.
What will you promise?
Phil Womble is kind of the thread that has held many generations of UCSB athletics together. I think he represents everything that is a Gaucho. He is incredibly inspirational. He's had to do a lot to overcome. He's been stricken with cerebral palsy since birth. No matter what obstacles he's faced, he's been able to overcome them, regardless of his physical restrictions. And I think he's kind of the guy who just never quits.
He's 75 years old, and he was expected to live a fraction of that. He's been with the department for so many years and just been really the heart and soul behind what we do here.
My baby boy in the baseball program at UCSB is unbelievable. I have made many friends. It's unbelievable.
The Phil Womble Hall of Champions is an incredible historical resource for this department. It's something that we did not have until we had the new Intercollegiate Athletics building.
We had an anonymous donor come forward who gave us money based on us dedicating it in Phil's name.
All of us wanted to have some place that could kind of reflect what we thought were the true values and honor the great tradition that we had here, particularly in our great new building. And of course, we were all very interested in having it named after the correct Gaucho.
I think that it had to be named after Phil. There was nobody else it could have been named for.
My dad was in the Navy, and when I was growing up, he taught me baseball, football, and basketball, in every sport that I love. I'm a sport guy. All right, so. Oh, God damn it!
Phil always reminds me we need to do it the right way. Gauchos don't just compete and we don't just excel, but we do it the right way. We've always been kind of underdogs, and we've always said, to heck with that. Let's just go out and beat whoever we need to beat, compete with whoever we need to compete.
We don't have a lot of money. We don't have a lot of resources, but we have such a strong program in spite of the excuses that we could use. And I think that's what Phil is all about. He could have every excuse in the book to you know, never leave his house or to never have lived the life that he's lived. He could have given up a long time ago, and you know, Gauchos never give up.
Phil is kind of that guy who just has really driven himself to overcome. And I think UCSB athletes, by and large, do the same thing. And he is incredibly representative of that spirit.
It's named in my name. It blew my mind. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Karlon Johnson, and I'm a fourth year 400 meter and 4x4 relay runner on the track and field team here at UCSB. Last year, I missed nearly my entire season due to a tear in my ACL. It was at the All UC meet in Irvine, and I got into kind of a collision during the 4x4 race. I was second leg, and that just devastated my ACL. I didn't think that I tore my ACL at the time, but when I found out, I knew that my whole season last year was just over. Or what kept me motivated to come back strong were my teammates. I love my teammates so much, and their support really helped me stick through like the hard times. My 4x4 teammates just do very well last year. That also motivated me to want to come back and also be a part of such greatness. My whole recovery process was like 7 to 8 months total. I would just stop by and see and check how everyone was doing, but I was kind of on the sidelines and just in the training room every day. It was definitely a change of scenery for me. Over the summer, my surgeon kind of gave me permission to start at least doing light runs, light jogs. And by November, I got full clearance to run without my brace. And even then, I was still kind of shaky, still slow. It still felt very awkward running without a brace. I think that having a positive attitude is just synonymous with like recovering and just feeling great. I don't think having a negative attitude is gonna help me in any type of way. When you're optimistic and open and receptive towards people, like people will want to support you as well, especially when you're going through such a hard time. My mom, I mean, she drove me from back and forth up here when I was going to have my surgery. She was there with me throughout the whole entire surgery process. Also, just other students around UCSB saw me in crutches and they were willing to help me and also just show moral support. I remember one time just walking across campus and someone stopped me and just wanted to pray for my leg, and I was just like, whoa, that was pretty deep, and it's so nice of them they didn't have to do that. I feel like I have no reason to be negative or bitter towards anyone or anything. I am very happy to be back, and I'm just ready to start this season with a bang, just ready to represent the Gauchos in the best way I can.
Looking for the best in Gaucho gear? Look no further than shopucsbgauchos.com. UCSB Athletics is pleased to announce the debut of our new online store, shopucsbgauchos.com. Gaucho fans can now find thousands of items to choose from. It is the biggest assortment of Gaucho gear ever assembled under one roof. With a full line of women's and youth apparel, performance gear, sweatshirts, tees, and headwear, shopucsbgauchos.com has something for everybody. Grab yourself or someone you love something new from the Gaucho shop at shopucsbgauchos.com today.
For UCSB Athletics, I'm Taja Davis, and that's all for this week's episode of Gauchos In 30. For all of your Gaucho gear needs, don't forget to visit shopucsbgauchos.com. And lastly, for more videos like these and for ways to buy tickets online, visit ucsbgauchos.com. See you next week for another episode of Gauchos In 30.